Okay, I guess we're up to the commission member reports. My particular area of liaison is capital projects. We've already talked about the historic fleet, so my primary interest is in completing our track upgrade. We're investing probably $1 million or slightly less than that in bringing the railroad into this century. I like to describe it when we're talking with the legislatures as the two states bought a piece of junk. And it wasn't quite that bad, but certainly the road grade, the whole track, 64 miles, was not something you really wanted to operate day in and day out. It had many, many problems. So we're replacing ties at a rapid rate. We're putting a lot of ballast into the whole structure of the railroad, and I'm very pleased that every time I ask, John Matthew says, yes, we will be completed on this upgrade program. We will have recovered from the condition that the railroad was in when we bought it by 2023. And I'm confident as we close in on that target that we will be there. And so we will have, I would say, probably the envy of the industry in terms of our track by the time we're through with that. And so we started at a very low point, and we're going to finish that program at a very high point. And then it will be up to us to maintain that high point going forward, and I'm comfortable that we've certainly created the base for that to happen. So with that, I'll turn it to Bill and have you talk about your area of activity or supervision, the finance area.
Well, I have the easy job to follow what Ed has presented, and I was very pleased with the detailed reports that I reviewed, being on track in so many areas, and the allocations of capital into the right segments, and particularly the track that we're working on. And things are I think right in line with where we would want them to be, not only from the standpoint of this fiscal year, but the appropriations that are going to be coming our way were well received. It was fun to go to the legislature, as we have done, and receive, rather than being grilled over why do you need this money, congratulations on a good job being done. And obviously that's not the commissioners that get credit for that, but John and his whole staff gets credit for that. So this is a wonderful project, and the finances are doing well, sir.
Thank you, Bill. Any questions? I mean, jump in if you want. Mark, would you care to say a few things over what you've already said?
Sure. Can I make a brief comment?
Totally.
On this subject, an important thing to remember here is that this is a social enterprise. It is a nonprofit. And Dan and the rest of the commissioners have been very wise in recognizing that we cannot forever continue, much as they love us at the moment in New Mexico and in Colorado. And in New Mexico, they've loved us for a long time. But if you'll remember a couple, 3 years ago, they loved us without any money. So it became very clear that we need to have a path to being self-sustaining. When Ed talked briefly about our NOI, the thing to remember is that at the end of fiscal 2023, our plan is that we will in fact stand on our own 2 feet. So anything that might in a normal business be seen as profit that would go to the stockholders actually is money that will be reinvested in making sure that we're able to continue employment for all of our people and continue to make the upgrades and maintenance necessary to keep this project viable. And we will no longer have to rely on vicissitudes of legislative whim. So that's, I just wanted to make that clear.
Thank you, John.
Well, my job is fairly easy as well, since we had Betsy here earlier and I made comments already. Just want to stress one of the comments that I brought up earlier. The employees here really make the marketing side of things so much easier. When you look at the Troy research and you've got a 90% complimentary guest service rating, that is just gigantic. So that is never overlooked by any of us. So just our greatest thanks go out to the staff who put their heart into the railroad every day.
Thank you and amen for certain. All right, Billy.
I have the easiest job here because I have Kim.
I want you to say something once in a while. Kim is great. I enjoy her. I don't know.
Why would I spoil the show with me speaking?
Well, okay, that's a good point.